Come on, get on your feet this morning. Come on, get on your feet this morning and give Jesus some praise. We celebrate that holy night that Jesus born into this world. Jesus lived the perfect life. We celebrate, we exalt Jesus today. Amen. Come on in this place. I'm so excited to be with you this morning. You can remain standing for the reading of God's word. And this is our Christmas celebration. I absolutely love all of us being in here for one service. You guys are looking great this morning. And I want to remind you, next week, we have one service at 10 o'clock next week again. And then January 9th, we go back to two services. But I'm reminded of last week, and I'm just overwhelmed by the message that we received from Pastor Sarah in the arrival last week. Put your hands together for Pastor Sarah. If you missed that, make sure you go to YouTube and watch that message. Today, I want you to turn with me in your Bible to Luke 2:20. Luke 2:20. Turn with me right now. This is a story of the shepherds. And the shepherds were taking care of their flocks, and an angel appears to them. They're scared, and the angel says, "Don't be afraid. I'm bringing you good news. There's a king, a savior, that's wrapped in swaddling clothes and in a manger." Immediately they go and they see Jesus. Can you imagine the moment when these shepherds, when they saw Jesus? But how did they respond to seeing Jesus? I want you to look to Luke 2:20. It says this: "The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told." They returned glorifying, come on somebody, and praising and exalting the name of Almighty God. We're in this place for one reason and one reason only. That's to exalt the name of Jesus. Come on somebody. Today I want to speak to you for a few moments on the Christmas wrap up. Come on, we're wrapping it up. The Christmas wrap up. Let's bow our heads and pray. God, we love you. We praise your name. Jesus, thank you for coming into this world, living the perfect life and defeating death, hell, and the grave so that we could be with you forever. God, bless this message. Bless my friends. Help us to have a great time with you. In Jesus' name we pray. And everybody said, hey, get three high fives. We got a lot of people up in here. Get three high fives and you can be seated. The Christmas wrap-up. Christmas, we're wrapping Christmas up, and some of you guys, you're dreading going back home because it's like a tsunami of presents and food has gone through your house. Wrapping paper is everywhere. There's food on your carpet. There's food everywhere, and you don't want to go home and put up your Christmas tree and your Christmas lights. I'm one of those people, okay? I don't want to go clean up. Some of you are OCD people, and you followed around your little kids as they open their presents with a trash bag. And as they open, you said, "All right, yeah, put the trash here. Go say your thank you. Say thank you. Put your trash here." I want to tell you, you need to ease up a little bit, okay? Enjoy Christmas, because the best part of Christmas is your kids. One of my favorite things about Christmas is waking Doc and Daisy and Kennedy and Noah up for Christmas morning. And Doc was so excited this Christmas that I didn't even have to wake him up. He came in. He was like, "Is it Christmas, Daddy?" I was like, "Yeah." And he's like, "Oh, what? It's Christmas today? Can I go wake up Daisy? I want to tell Daisy." So he goes up and knocks on Daisy's door and comes in there. And Daisy's like, "Oh, it's Christmas? Is it time?" And I just love seeing the faces on these kids. But here's the thing. Waking up for Christmas, it's not the end of the day. Come on, somebody. It's the very beginning. It's the beginning of celebrating the birth of Christ and all the festivities. We're just finishing 2021. It's the year of awakening. It's the last Sunday of the year, and this has been a year of awakening. But I'm here to proclaim to you today, it's not over. The best is still yet to come. 2022, God's going to bring some goodness and some amazing things. But before we go on, we're still in 2021. I want to celebrate some of the good stuff God did in 2021. How many of you, God did some incredible things? You had some breakthroughs. God answered some prayers. Come on. You got some miracles. God did some amazing things. I want to tell you, here at SC Church, it's been the year of awakening. And God has done phenomenal things. And just a few things is we have grown young here at SC Church. What does that mean? Well, we have invested in our children and in our youth, giving them a platform to minister and experience God like never before. Pastor Stephanie McNeely, Pastors Josh and Lacey Bradall, I love our kids pastors and our youth pastors and everything that God's doing in our young people. Put your hands together for the young people of this church. I'm telling you, it was an awakening. Encounters. Encounters were a weekend that we went off just us and Almighty God, and we experienced God's presence. We're going to do that in 2022. We had I Love West Shreveport, two serve days, and there were 450 of you servant leaders that invested in West Shreveport, local businesses, local churches, local schools. And we have a new vision outside of this South Foyer. We have SC Market and Ethan's Garden. I'm so excited about this property because we completed the first two phases of this vision, and the best is yet to come out there. Community groups. How many of you guys were in community groups this last season? Well, we had 60 groups, the most groups we've had, 475 members in these community groups. Connect Sundays and Serve Team Sundays. What is that? Well, that is a time that people became members, come on, of this church and said, I'm going to serve the Church of Jesus Christ. 123 people completed these classes. And then we had 103 baptisms, water baptisms on celebration Sundays, and hundreds of salvations. People are getting saved in this place. And you say, well, what about missions? I just want to thank you guys because this church, SC Church, you gave thousands of dollars to missions this past year. And on this campus, you, in time of need, gave away 50,000 water bottles and 10,000 meals to West Shreveport. You say, Denny, why are you just listing off all of these things that you've done? Are we just patting ourselves on the back? No, friends, everything that we've done, it's not for SC Church, it's in the name of Jesus Christ. It's to exalt the name of Jesus, to draw people to the church. Come on, put your hands together this morning for everything that you did. Come on, we can do better than that. Put your hands together for the year of awakening. God did some great things. And I'm so proud of you. I love each and every one of you. But you say, what now? What do we do now? Now that we're awake, now we're awakened, what's the next step? Now that we have new love, new life, a new promise, a new vision, how do we respond? Well, in the Christmas wrap-up, I think the Christmas story, it gives us some characters in the Christmas story, and I love it. And whenever these characters, whenever they see Jesus, how they respond to Jesus is how we're to step into the next season. How they respond to Jesus is how we're to step into 2022. So the first character and the first response is the wise men. I love the wise men so much. Their response after they saw Jesus was that they had a new ability to hear from Almighty God. They had a new ability to hear from Almighty God. These guys were experts. They were scientists, astrologers. They found Jesus on their own. But I want you to know, these wise men finding Jesus on their own got them in trouble. How? Well, they went through Herod, and it ultimately resulted in thousands of babies losing their lives. But once they found Jesus, they saw Jesus, the Savior of the world. God came to them in a dream, and he said, don't go back the same way that you came. Go back a different way. You have a new ability to hear from Almighty God. Yes, you found me in your own understanding, but now that you've seen me, you're leaving with a new ability, a new direction, a new purpose, a new way to hear the voice of Almighty God. That's my prayer for us in 2021, that we'll experience God this year, but in stepping into 2022, that we'll have a new ability to hear from God, that we'll have a new ability to take his direction. It's not our understanding, it's God's understanding. It's not our direction, it's God's direction. Just like the wise men, you have the ability to hear from God in a new way. The second response is from Joseph. Joseph is Jesus' earthly caretaker. I love Joseph so much. And his response is, from seeing Jesus, he took great responsibility to protect what God had given him. After the wise men left, Joseph had a dream from God to go to Egypt to protect Jesus. After Herod died, he had another dream to go back to Israel. On his way back to Israel with Jesus and Mary, well, he heard that Herod's son became the king, so he didn't want to take any chances. He took Jesus to Nazareth and raised him, fulfilling the prophecy, he will be called a Nazarene. Everything in Joseph's life was to protect what God gave. And I want to tell you today that as your pastor, I feel a heavy responsibility to protect what God has given. Your community group leaders feel the same responsibility. And if you've ever known the fierce fighting love of a mama bear with her little cub, that is how Joseph was with Jesus. His whole life was to protect this little boy's life in what God had given. How many of you were given some things from Almighty God this past year? How many of you had some experiences? Maybe you took a step towards what God said to do in serving. Maybe you had a miracle. I want to tell you this. Whatever God has given you, it is your responsibility, your response to protect from the enemy, from the world, the flesh, the devil, that word you received in that encounter, that moment that you had in taking a step forward in serving, whatever God has given you with everything in your heart, just like Joseph. Friends, we got to protect what God has given us. Come on, put your hands together if you're going to protect what God has given us. The next response is Mary. I'm going to get y'all out of here. Come on, you got to clean up. Clean your house up. I got to clean. I'm right there with you. Mary's next response is one of my favorites. Because Mary, did you know, just thinking about the relationship of the mother of God and what she did, how did she respond to having Jesus in her home? Well, the Bible says two times, her response was this. Mary pondered it in her heart. Mary pondered it in her heart after the shepherds left. She pondered it in her heart after Jesus was at the synagogue when he was 12 years old. What is that? Well, she treasured Jesus being with her. And here in this place, you know, those of us know that we're in this thing called Christianity. Okay, I'm in. I got salvation. Now what's next? I don't know the next step, but all you want to do is cherish your relationship with Jesus. All you want to do right now is worship Jesus and ponder your... Can I tell you that's enough? That pondering your relationship is enough and it results in the promises of Almighty God. You know, my little boy, Doc, he's a Spider-Man fanatic, okay? And every time you see him, if he's... Don't be offended at him. He's shooting Spider-Man webs at you, okay? He's Hulk. If he comes up and just punches you in your back, that's a sign of love, okay? That's the Hulk smash right in your back. He loves you, okay, if he hits you. Well, I wasn't a Marvel person growing up. I was a DC Comics guy. Any Spider-Man fans out here? That's my generation. We have one person here, okay? No one else. So Superman was my guy. What is a Superman story? He comes from Krypton, another world. And he comes down, he's a little baby, he's so powerful, Superman, and then these two parents, these earthly parents, raise him. The mother in the story is so significant because she cherishes the relationship of Superman, raises him, loves him. And when it's time, Superman rips his shirt off, reveals his S, dun-dun-dun-dun, and he saves everyone around him, right? Well, it's a lot like Jesus and Mary. Think about Mary. Mary gives birth to the Son of God. She has Almighty God in her home. Jesus, she's not a busy bee that has all the answers. She's got to check off all the lists. She's not getting Jesus on a sleeping rotation, making sure he's not having YouTube and doing all these little... No, she is pondering, treasuring every moment with Jesus as a boy, as a young child, as a young man, until it was time for Jesus to step out into ministry. And who was it that gave Jesus the nudge, the one that pondered him, the one that treasured him? I want to tell you this. You might not know what to do with your next step, but Jesus and Almighty God is enough. Experience an Almighty God. If you just ponder and treasure and steward your relationship with him, you will know your next, and it will blow your mind. I want Alex to go ahead and come up here. I'm going to close. And my last response is this. It's the shepherds. I love these shepherds so much. The story of the shepherds is they're off in their field, and they're watching their sheep, right? I mean, they're shepherds. They're just watching their flock. And all of a sudden, an angel appears to them. But understand, it's been hundreds and hundreds of years before, since a prophet has even heard from God, since a word from God has been revealed. It's been hundreds of years of darkness. They're not used to angels disappearing. So it terrifies them. They're like, what? What is this? And he says, don't be scared. I got good news for you, little buddy. Things are going to be all right. In fact, I have the best news possible for you guys. There is the Savior of the world, and he's wrapped in swaddling clothes. He's laying in a manger, and you need to go see him. Well, they hear from the angel, the word of God, and they act immediately. I want to tell you this. Whenever you get a word from God, you got to act immediately. Whenever you get a drawing from the Holy Spirit, do what's right and do it right now. They moved immediately, and they saw Jesus in the manger. And what did they do? They worshiped him and they glorified him. But what was their response? The shepherd's response was they went and they told the world. And all that listened were marveled and believed. I want to tell you this, that we've experienced Jesus. So many of us have seen the face of Jesus, and it's glorious. The best day of your life, the best day of my life is when I said yes to Jesus. When I said, Jesus, I love you. When I saw the face of Jesus. But your divine destiny, your divine calling, your divine purpose is reached the very first day you turn. And you tell someone else about Jesus. You take them by the hand and they follow you, following Jesus back to the cross. I want to tell you this today. There's a bunch of empty seats in this room. There's a bunch of filled seats. There's a bunch of evangelists. There's a bunch of people that have experienced Almighty God. If anything that we take from 2021 is this, we got to tell the world what Almighty God has done for us. We got to tell the world that Jesus is the reason for the season. And we got to share it with them because it will transform their entire lives. How do we respond to Jesus? Well, I pray this. I pray that moving on to the next season, you'll be like the wise men. I pray that no longer you'll go under your own understanding, but you'll say, God, I want your understanding. Say, God, I don't want my direction. I want your direction. And I'm praying to God, you'll have a new ability to hear from God. I pray like Joseph. You've been given some words. You've been given some promises. And some of those promises have not come to pass. But that word, you protect it. You protect everything Jesus has done for you. Just like Mary, you ponder your relationship with God. Treasure it because God is enough. And in exalting Jesus, we're able to tell the world. And the world is changed from our experience. I want to tell you, 2021 was spectacular. But 2022, come on, somebody. The best is yet to come. Stand to your feet this morning and give God some praise. Come on, stand to your feet this morning and give God some praise if you love him. Thank you, Jesus.